everyone. Ian here, and behind me is a new listing. This particular vessel is a 1987 Tiara Yachts 36 Open. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that it has to offer.
Here we are starting out the bow, and as you can see, this is a beautiful vessel. It was just buffed and waxed and is really showing its best. The Tiara Yachts is a very popular, well-known, very respected yacht that really holds up in time, as you can see. Being it's a 1987, this particular vessel really, really shows, you know, it's being very well cared for and just offers a great platform, not only for offshore fishing capabilities, but really just enjoying, you know, the water, your family, and just getting out of the bay. We have a nice swim platform here right at the back of the vessel. The teak was just recently cleaned as well too. Entry door here, which allows easy access into the boat itself. There is a swim drop down ladder, gaining access from the water into the boat itself. Lots of storage down below here, but this is an incredible aft cockpit. Just great for lounging, hanging out. You could put tables or additional chairs if so desired, but a phenomenal cockpit. Great for fishing again, hanging out. And then right now, I'm gonna take you up to the foredeck. As we walk around the foredeck itself, there are nice side decks here, gaining us access to the bow of the vessel. There are three overhead opening hatches, allowing lots of ventilation down below. But again, another great area here for lounging. There is an electric windlass. This is a Maxwell windlass, up and down control switches here, access to the anchor locker, and a really nice bowsprit as well. Coming back around, you have large stainless steel lifelines. We have opening windows on both starboard and port side with the fixed window center line there. And then the bimini itself overhead and over the aft cockpit. All right. As we walk down into the aft cockpit again, this will show you just how large this area truly is. Underneath here, we have additional storage, and there is a little compartment that will house a ice maker. So I'm not sure if this is operational, but this is a great little, cockpit bar here. Built-in sink, 110 outlet. And again, when not in use, this closes up and locks into place. We have really quick engine access down through this center locker. This opens up and gains us access to the engines themselves. Currently, the generator is non-operational, but that is just how the current owners purchased the boat. Aft-facing seat, we have two forward-facing seats. Off to the starboard side is the helm. We have throttle controls. We all have transmission controls. Our lighting switches here, Furuno radar, GPS map, VHF, RPM gauges, and instrumentations here. Compass mounted up on top of the dash. And again, look at this, phenomenal visibility. Again, for its age, it really possesses a lot of boat. Storage on both areas underneath the bench seats. This large sliding companionway door opens up and leads us down with three steps, two into the galley and one into the salon. The galley's off to the port side. The galley itself is set up with a large refrigeration freezer compartment. We have a microwave, lots of storage throughout, a double stainless steel sink there, and storage underneath the sink as well. Beautiful teak and holly floors, teak interior, a large settee off to the starboard side with that dinette table that will actually drop down, and there is a filler cushion that turns this into an additional berth. Here we have controls to the air conditioning system. We also have our 12-volt and 110 breaker controls there. VHF, RAM mic, and additional speakers. Opening ports, so there's one thing that this does have is a lot of side opening ports, overhead ports, what I showed you before. There is a upgraded Fusion Bluetooth stereo unit as well too. Directly across from the settee area is the head and shower compartment. This is a VacuFlush style toilet, a walk-in shower, nice sink, another opening port overhead, and outboard. You do have private access through this door into the master cabin. Here we have a centerline, almost modified queen berth, storage areas, both to starboard and port side. There are three opening hatches here, so it is quite ventilated. This will give us a nice perspective looking aft. All right, so if you're looking for a solid offshore cruiser, great for fishing, family, fun out on the bay, that doesn't break the bank, this is something you should really seriously take a look at. For additional information, please call me at any time, day or night. Thank you again. Bye for now.